Since the early 1930s, the Duke University Chapel has stood on the highest ridge of Duke's West Campus. This iconic building has rich history and is known for its architectural grandeur. Over the past 8 decades, Duke University Chapel has celebrated thousands of services, welcomed millions of guests, and served as the preeminent icon for the university. In May of 2015, Duke University kicked off a year-long restoration project to rehabilitate the interior and exterior of the chapel. Pur Vent, a full-service HVAC cleaning and sealing company, was tasked with restoring the entire HVAC system, including 100 feet of underground ductwork. To tackle this project, Pur Vent chose Carlisle HVAC product RE500. A high-performance, spray-applied insulation encapsulant and coating for use inside the HVAC ductwork.
My name is Henry Baker. I'm with Pur Vent in Cary, North Carolina. We do HVAC restoration. We do both airside and waterside. We clean ductwork, air handling units, cooling towers, condensing units, boilers. If it has to do with the HVAC system, we can clean it. Currently, we are at Duke University Chapel cleaning the existing ductwork. The scope of the project, for as far as the heating and air conditioning was concerned, was they were replacing the existing air handling units. Our scope of work was to clean all the ductwork and grills that remained. They expanded that to include about 100 feet of underground fresh air duct that originally had been taken out of service. They decided they were going to put it back in service, and they wanted to coat it. We proposed the RE500 system from Carlisle Hardcast. We had to go in and clean the ductwork first with vacuums, and then now we're going to go in again with air whips and a negative pressure on the opposite side of the duct, and then blow it out with whips and air washing. Then we're going to go back with RE500 and hand spray it with an airless sprayer. Some of the grills were brass, and there was a possibility of scratching those. We had to use special tape onto the air distribution because anything worse or any kind of duct mask would have peeled away portions of the limestone and discolored the limestone, so you would have seen a noticeable stripe where you had put it. Also, the air distribution was literally on top of the woodwork, and the entire back of the seats were the air plenum. So we had to go down the back of that and clean that out, and that was getting zoning and enough suction on that was a nightmare. Architects and engineers are starting to realize that you can't just replace an air handling unit and just leave the ductwork and the air distribution at 30 years old and with dirt caked on that thick. It just doesn't work, and especially if you put new ducts downstream from it. I've seen the dirt from the old ductwork blow into that, and then they had to clean the whole thing. My crews really like the RE500 because it goes into the airless sprayer well, it doesn't clog it up, goes on, creates a nice even coat. It was low VOC. It was used inside of an HVAC system, whereas some of the other products that were being kicked around were not. Works better, costs less. How can you beat that?